represents a drug, or what the Greeks called a pharmakon. The pharmakon is a filter which acts as both a remedy and a poison. As a pharmakon affects the individual, so the individual affects culture. The serpent, Moses, Jesus, and Socrates are social pharmakons who vaccinate their respective cultures with their drug-inspired revolutionary discourse. Their discourse challenges the current tradition, or rather disrupts the current tradition, but even that revolution is part of the tradition. Therefore, if you are in a position of authority, political, economic, scientific, art, figures such as Jesus and Socrates undermine that authority. Their inspired discourse represents a virus that must be contained before the whole culture can be infected. Psychedelic mushrooms are a gateway to that cosmic consciousness, a door to the kingdom of heaven. However, the door is locked and there is a no trespassing sign nailed to it. In the United States, it is a felony to possess mushrooms containing the psychoactive alkaloids psilocybin and psilocine, and for the first time conviction, punishable by loss of federal benefits, forfeiture of personal and private property, up to a year in prison, fine not more than $100,000. According to the poet Robert Graves, the ancient Israelites practiced something similar. He writes, "The Hebrews held the mushroom holy and reserved them for their priests, kings, and other privileged classes. And to prevent the underprivileged from eating a sacred mushroom, a general seyeg, or taboo, was put on all mushroom eating and reinforced by treating all mushrooms as poisonous. By indoctrinating a culture into regarding mushrooms as poisonous, the whole culture is ignorant of this God-derived knowledge and fears the mushroom is deadly. Meanwhile, the priestly caste develops scripture as a way to preserve this culture, a tradition that goes back to Moses and the second version of the Ten Commandments." Moses is coming down the mountain with the two stone tablets of testimony inscribed by God when he discovers that the tribe has abandoned his precepts. Furthermore, they have resorted to their former ways by dancing ecstatically around the image of a golden calf. He throws down the tablets, breaking them, and smashes the golden calf. Then Moses says, "Whoever is for the Lord, come with me." To those who come with him, he instructs, "Each man strap a sword to his side, go back and forth through the camp from one end to the other, each killing his brother and friend and neighbor." Exodus 32:27. With the camp free of malcontents, Moses goes back to the mountain and in secrecy carves out a new set of tablets. The first set of tablets broken by Moses were created by the Lord. However, the tablets that the people received are actually carved out by Moses, and he wrote on the tablets the word of the covenant, the Ten Commandments, Exodus 34:28. Moses effectively substitutes the laws of God with the laws of man. He takes the mushrooms, throws them to the ground, and instead gives man written laws.